Hi, my name is Jairaj and welcome to another video of annotation series. And in this tutorial, we will learn at the rate override annotation. So this annotation is a part of general annotations in Java's built-in annotations. And this is the signature of annotation. And as you can see here, it is a marker annotation, meaning it doesn't have any element or value. Only the presence of it can tell a compiler about it. And as I mentioned previously, that all annotations have two basic properties: target and retention. And for override, target is method, because overriding concept doesn't make sense for class, annotations or variables. It is only for methods. And the retention policy for override is a source, meaning at the runtime there is no use of this annotation, because at the time of compilation we decide method overriding is properly done or not, and based on that it creates .class file. So use of this annotation is to make sure method is properly overridden or not. Meaning, let's take an example of interface employee and class manager. So we have one interface named employee, which has one method getSalary, return type integer. And in manager class, we are extending employee interface and we are overriding this method. So now let's say a programmer made mistake at the time of coding. Instead of getSalary, he wrote getSalary with double L, just a spelling mistake. Or let's say he made a mistake in argument type. So without override annotation, it won't generate any error at the time of compilation. So what will compiler do is, compiler will create a separate method with the name getSalary with double L, and which can create a lot of problem for us because we didn't override our actual method and we introduced new method. So use of this annotation is to generate errors. So we are telling compiler that we are overriding this particular method. If anything is not fitting together, just generate an error. So in this anything, we can put a spelling mistake, we can put return type, argument type, anything is not right, then generate an error. So benefit of using this annotation is readability of code. So every time as a developer, we see this @override annotation on top of any method, we get to know that this particular method is being override. And second one is, if for any reason we have to change function signature in the interface, then we have to find each and every class which is overriding this method manually and need to fix that. But with this annotation, compiler will tell us that these are the classes that is being wrongly overridden, or nowadays modern IDEs also can tell you about it, so which can save a lot of time for us. So that's why this override annotation is very important in coding as well as to save time. And that's all for now in this tutorial, and thanks for joining it.